Hi, I'm John Sanders, and today I want to take you all on a tour of my property in Roxbury, New York, where I'm developing a sculpture park, and you will be looking at work I've done in the last 17 years since I moved in here in 1994. I hope you'll enjoy the experience. And now we're going to have a look at my beloved indoor studio, which at 300 feet long and 40 feet wide dwarfs everything that I had in New York City. And inside here, you'll see works of mine since the 1970s. And that includes work in steel, copper, bronze, and stainless. Let's have a look. Here we're looking at some of my first forged pieces that I did in New York City in the 80s, and these are bronze castings and pieces from the 80s and 90s in New York City that were shown. So in this space you will see some of the smaller pieces in stainless steel that I executed in the years 2011 and 2012. You'll also see some wall pieces that incorporate color for the first time in my work. They're elemental colors in copper, bronze, stainless, and brass. I've been using colors for the first time, and I've been hedging against it since my father is such a terrific abstract expressionist painter, and he uses colors that I can't imagine. Here you will see some more wall pieces that are recent, and you will be looking at some forged sculptures of mine executed over the last 20 years. This is one of my first large indoor stainless pieces done in about 2008. And as we work our way around the room, we're coming to one of my favorite stainless steel pieces executed in 2009. That's a solid copper and bronze piece. And there's a small bronze and wall pieces. Here we have three small stainless pieces done in the last 2 years. In this sequence, we will be looking at my larger copper, bronze, stainless, and brass pieces, some of which have been shown in the early 2000s, or right up until today. Now I want you to see my indoor studio, which is the only one that I can heat in the winter. And that's important because at this age, I don't have to go to Hawaii for the winter, and I'm able to execute works here year round. So now if we look down here, we'll see this bandsaw that I use to cut the steel, stainless, and bronze into various sizes. And I make up almost a whole library of shapes, so that when I'm executing my pieces, I don't have to, I have all the shapes that I need readily available, so I don't have to manufacture for each individual piece. I have them already. And these are the organic shapes of various sizes that I incorporate into the final works. And I find that this arrangement works very well for me. All right, so now we're upstairs in the barn, and you can see these masks or wall pieces that I consider to be like self-portraits, because why not? I did them. And I'd like you now to take a walk with me around the barn as I see it. From here, we can take a real good view of the upstairs of the barn, which includes the newer barn, which is here, and the old barn down there, which is from the 1860s, and I'm lucky that I was able to keep it. because as you can see, it's wired together. And that makes the whole space all the more wonderful for me. And now I think it would be good if I could show you how I've cut the floor out here. And this is something that is typical of me. I've done it in all my studios, and even in New York City, where I did it and I was able to get away with it because I didn't have any inspectors at that time in the 70s in New York City. So this gives you a chance to look down on the sculptures, which I find very important because oftentimes they're seen from offices above looking down. Now we're looking at some of my early blacksmith and forge bent pieces that I executed in the 1990s. I showed many of these in New York City. These for me were a big transition from my heavy geometric pieces that I did as a young man in my 20s and 30s. And I really have enjoyed opening up more and becoming more fluid and having more movement in the work. And this is how they went with many different ideas for larger sculptures. All right, so now I'm going to show you my outdoor sculptures that I've worked on for the last 10 years. And it's good when you look at them that you realize the nature behind all of it, because I'm not used to that. That's why my early sculptures have been so architectural when I was living in the city. But I think that you can see from these pieces that you're going to be looking at that I've become a bit more organic now that I've been in the country for so long. And I try to mix the two together, but it's difficult to fight off this beautiful nature. All right, this is one of my most recent big pieces. This is 2011, and since it looks like a harp, I've decided to call it Harpo. And I think it's wonderful that I'm able to position all these larger sculptures on these lower terraces, which are also a kind of an earthwork. And so by positioning the pieces, I'm sort of making their own environment. And because of the way they lay out, it gives me ideas for the next sculptures to go in between. All right, now we're in my outdoor studio here in Roxbury, and this is the largest piece that I've executed here, and I'm still finishing now in the summer of 2012. So now I'm going to take you out to the first field that I bulldozed, and it used to go straight downhill, so you can understand why I had to do it. And I placed my first large pieces right out here. Now we are looking at pieces that I have done in the last 5 years. They show different ways of working in steel. And at the end, the final piece you will see is closer to my more geometric early work. This is the first upper field that I have made. And in this field, we see many of my mid-size pieces that I've executed over the last 25 years. What a beautiful view. It's changed my life. Now that I live up here, I realize I've been thinking about why I do the things I do. And other people ask me also. And I say that when I wake up in the morning, I have no choice. This is my job in life. The truth is that I'm fascinated by putting things together and have them look interesting in three dimensions. These works look light,
but they're extremely heavy. And I think that that's something that I've learned over the years to do. They're almost blowing in the wind. People ask me, what are you trying to say? And I always find this quite upsetting, because that's why the language is sculpture instead of English. And I think you have to determine what they look like and what they're saying for yourself. And over the years, writers and collectors and critics all have their own idea of what I'm trying to say. And the only real answer is that they're all about sex. You see? Sex is involved in all things of nature, and steel is part of nature.
So now, as we get to the top of the hill, I've put some of my earliest stone carvings, which preceded all my work in steel, so that these works are from the early and late 1970s. And if you see that one over there, that was when I started combining stones together. And that led to the steel sculptures later that you've seen already. So right now we're at the top of the property where my stones are, and we're going to look down at the steel sculptures that I've done over the past 20, 30 years. And this is such a delight for me that I get to place these in different positions and get to see them in all different frames of reference.
Bulldozing this mountain into different shapes and forms is just an extension of my carvings in steel and stone. In the past few years, I have begun to realize how fragile and impermanent life really is. It is filled with pain, loss, change, and joy. I feel unbalanced by all the emotions that go with these experiences. I love the permanence of all my materials I use to create art. I have the small joy in knowing they will outlive me and perhaps give some good experience to others. This is especially true since they are my only children. Thanks for taking the time to experience my country studio and seeing my life's work.